What's up, guys? This is the Anime King David here back with the review for Anime Arc, Yu-Gi-Oh! Arc V. Episode 57. This continues. 57. This continues after the last episode where Sarutari and Selena finished fighting the Duel Chasers. After that, they went on their way, and they found a very interesting duelist, Crow Hogan. As we all know, Crow Hogan and Jack Atlas, the protagonist of the original Yu-Gi-Oh! 5D's 5D's arc, do live in that dimension and do live in those common city of the dimension. And what Crow Hogan did is that he saw the trouble everybody was in and found a safe place, more of like his own home, to basically guard these guys from being chased by the Duel Chaser. And basically they talk about Yuya, and the guys talk about how they got there in the first place, how they came from another universe, another dimension, or you could call it a different universe if you like to, a different dimension. Basically, they come as the Lancers. They're trying to convince Crow Hogan that they came here to, help his dimension. They came to find some of their friends that were important to them. And Crow Hogan and basically everyone in that dimension kind of does actually disbelieve these guys. They don't really understand what's actually going on around here with the dimensional war, with the academia and trying to confuse all four dimensions together. And Crow Hogan seems to have a hard time believing this, but he does actually believe about their friends being missing. And he said, "I'll go out myself and try to find them for you." And, basically the commons are going through such a hard time, hardship, not only with trying to find food to eat, but trying to put a home over their heads. And it's very, very complicated living in that dimension. And Crow Hogan has these two kids in the house, which he's taking care of. And they even have to go around the dimension and try to find some food to bring back home so that they can make something at home, because this place, the whole dimension, that part of the dimension, so low on food. The top of the commons are very very going through a hardship at this point. And but Yuya does, because Crow understands, okay, these guys can't go out because of the Duel Chasers going after them. And he explains about this place called the it's more of like a concentration camp, I'd say, for the basically whenever the Duel Chasers catch you, when they catch a criminal, especially if they're from the commons, they send, basically it's more of like a lookout for the commons, just in case they try to do anything stupid, just in case they try to disrespect the laws and rules of that dimension. Basically, as we all know, the rules being, if you're from a different if you're a winner of that dimension, then you'll live a life of live the lap of luxury. You'll be part of the top. And if you're a loser, then you were basically, if you're a loser, or you are basically more of like a bluntly, a loser, you'll be part of the commons, and you'll live a life of you'll live a life of poverty. And what he explains is that if the Duel Chasers do actually catch you, they'll put you in these camps. So basically, it's like they'll catch you and put you in jail if they find you. And he explains how horrible it is to actually be there. And he says, I'd rather go out myself than see you guys actually go through that kind of stuff, because he's seen that kind of stuff happen to his own people before. So he goes out there, and that's basically the last we see of Crow Hogan in this part of the episode. And Yuzu and Yugo are going all across the city warning everybody about the upcoming threat, the dimensional war, how the fusion dimension's trying to kill everybody, how they're trying to turn everybody into cards. By the time they get to this dimension, everyone's going to be turned into cards, like, you know, she pointed out with these two cards with people still into them. No one in the dimension is actually believing anything these guys are saying. Vegas looking at these guys as psychopaths and walking just laughing at them, because Vegas don't believe in this kind of thing, this supernatural thing actually happening. And Yugo is actually trying to help Yuzu in order to prove to everybody that what they're saying is actually right. This is actually what's going on, and we have to team up very quickly in order to fight back at this. And you know, Yugo attempts to summon his clear wing Synchro Dragon, but since he's not in the duel, he can't really summon it. And he's talking about transcending through dimension at the speed of light, and then afterwards, his summon failed, and it just made him look like even more of an idiot. And basically, the guys believed him even more. And these guys are like, are these guys serious? You know, these two are actually making such fools of themselves. Are they actually, is this supposed to be a joke, or are they that stupid? And basically, that's all we see Yugo and Yuzu doing, just trying to prove to everybody that, you know, this is what's going on. And then we get to Dennis and the and Gogensaka. Basically, all of the Lancers have split all across the dimension. So basically, we have three people here, two people here, another three over there. And what happens is that Gogensaka and Dennis are in the middle of a street. With, as you all remember, Melissa Claire, the news reporter for Tops News TV, I believe, for the Synchro Dimension, is actually covering this duel, and these two are going at it, trying to entertain the kids, the children in the audience. Basically, this is more of an entertainment duel, where at the beginning, Dennis wanted to pretend that Gogensaka was the enemy and that he was an ally, the hero, and proving to the kids, you know, okay, he went, you know, teaching the kids basically, you know, how to be a hero. So then the whole duel basically flip-flops, and Gogensaka, you know, turns the tables on Dennis, making him the villain instead. And after all of this, Gogensaka actually got pretty angry at Dennis for, you know, being an asshole when they're supposed to be doing something more, much more important. So he said, okay, why are we doing this? You know, I have to go hard on you. I actually have to go all out on you, because I need to teach you how to, I need to go all out on you because I need to teach you how to actually be, you know, mature in this kind of situation, and teach you that this is not just about playing, you know. So basically, Gogensaka ends up winning against Dennis, and that duel part basically ends. And then at the end of the episode, we see this mysterious guy. I'm pretty sure, you know, no offense, but I'm pretty sure this is like the only black guy we're going to be seeing in Yu-Gi-Oh! RGV. But then he comes in all of a sudden, out of his limousine. He sees these guys using all of these different dueling techniques that no one in that dimension has ever seen before, including Dennis's Pendulum Summon and Gogensaka's Xyz Summon, and he even used Synchro Summon as well. And he's some sort of entrepreneur. He's he looks very rich. I mean, just looking at his getup, you know, his fancy sunglasses, jewelry, tuxedo. Apparently he's very professional in whatever the fuck he does. And then he comes over by these two and asks them, "Can I borrow your dueling techniques? I can make you guys very powerful duelists. I can have you guys beat all the very, very strong duelists." And he's trying to offer them some sort of ultimatum. Not really an ultimatum, but trying to get these guys an opportunity to, I guess it could be some sort of trap, some sort of scam, but we have to see for later. He doesn't really look that, you know, honest to me in what he's doing, but he says, okay, I can help you beat a whole bunch of strong duelists out there. And that's basically where the episode ends. So I give this episode about an 8.5 out of 10. I'm usually going to, on average, I give a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh! RGV episodes of 8.5 out of 10, but I believe that could be too high, maybe a 7 out of 10. What I believe what's going to happen for next episode is we're going to get more into, you know, the story for you, hopefully. Well, you know, it'll be a while until we get more. I think we've already gotten to the story for Yugo, But we're going to get into more of a story with Crow. Before that happens, he's going to go all around the city looking for these two. Usually when you go and use are still going to continue their attempt to get everyone in the city to understand what's going on and blah, 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 blah. And hopefully we'll get into Akaba and all the other guys who've been split apart in the dimension. And we're getting more into the tops and the commons. And I don't know what Gogenzaka and Dennis plan to do with this entrepreneur. If they're going to actually follow him or if they're going to just, decline his offer. But I definitely would like to see how that turns out. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this. Like, comment, subscribe, share. My name is the Anime King David. See you guys later. Peace.